Hello guys, welcome back to our lesson yet again. My name is Daisy Chepkorir and I'll be taking you through this lesson where we are going to look at three things, that is regular verbs ending with IR. We are going to look also at demonstratives, and finally we are going to look at the verb avoir, the expressions, I mean using the word avoir. Okay. Salut à tous, bienvenue dans notre leçon de troisième semaine. Je m'appelle Daisy Chepkorir et c'est moi qui va vous enseigner les verbes réguliers en utilisant qui se terminent par IR. Aussi, nous allons voir les démonstratifs et à la fin, nous allons voir les expressions basiques en utilisant le verbe avoir. So, this day, I excuse myself, the ink in my pen is ran out and I had to shoot it anyway. So what I'll do is I'll put the subtitle, so you make sure you follow, voila, and read the subtitles. All right, so there are many examples of verbs ending with IR. Okay, there is finir, to finish, finir, to finish. There is grandir, to grow. There is remplir, to fill. And there is réussir, to succeed, among others, many others. So what we're going to do is that we are going to conjugate them in present tense, okay? As I had mentioned previously, I had showed you guys how to conjugate the regular verbs ending with er in present tense. So this time around, it will be the ones ending with IR. So to begin with, let's take an example of the verb finir. Okay, the verb finir. So finir, we are going to remove the ending IR of finir and we are going to replace with the following. Okay, for I, je, je, for I, we are going to replace it with, IS, je finis, with to, you, I mean, je finis means I finish, to, you going to replace it, you're going to replace it with IS as well, to say to finis, you finish, to finis, il and l, you replace with IT, il finis, il finis, il finis, elle finis. For nous, you are going to replace with I-S-S-O-N-S. Nous finissons. Nous finissons. With vous, you are going to replace with I-S-S-E-Z to mean vous finissez. Vous finissez. Vous finissez. And lastly, with il and l, you are going to replace with I-S-S-E-N-T or I-S-S-E-N-T. To say il finis or elle finis, il finis, elle finis, they finish, okay, in feminine and masculine. I know by now you understand them. So that's pretty much how to conjugate them in present tense. You can as well, you know, do more examples with different verbs and it will be very exciting. So let's look at demonstratives. To say this, to say that, to say those, to say this, all that. So in French, we basically use the word ce and cet to say this or that. So you use ce for masculine and cet for feminine. So I can say ce train, this train, ce train, that train, okay? For something feminine, set, we are going to use the word set, okay? Cette chemise, this shirt, cette chemise, this shirt, okay? Cette chemise, also that shirt. But now in plural, for both of them, we are going to use C-E-S, okay? So C-E-S is like the feminine for both of them. Cette chemise, this shirts. And but now with a word that is, begins with a vowel or a h, we are going to use c-e-t set, not the one for feminine. I know you're making the difference right now. Set, like for example, helicopter, set hélicoptère, and many other examples. So make sure when it's followed by a vowel or a H, okay, voyelle or hash, you're going to use CET, all right. And for plural, for all of them, you're going to use CES, okay. So I also want to let you note that if you have to make a difference maybe between this shirt and that shirt, okay, you are going to use what you call C, a short form of EC, and you're going to use also la, a short form, not a short form, to say there. So with maybe let's say this train or and that train, and I have to make the difference between the two, I'll say ce train-ci, this train, ce train-ci, and ce train-là. Ce train-ci is like this train. Ce train-là is like that train. You see, ce train-là, ce train-ci, ce train-là. So that will pretty much bring the difference between the two when you're using when there is need. Okay, so off to something else. Let's look at the basic expressions using the word avoir. Avoir is the verb to say I have, or to have. Sorry, yeah, it's the verb to say to have. We had looked at it previously, and this time around we are going to look at basic expressions. I had mentioned that it was very important because with some expressions you have to use avoir. Like in English, you can say I am hungry, but in French you are going to say j'ai faim. It's like I have a hunger. So in French, with the basic expressions with the word avoir, we have avoir faim, to say to be hungry, avoir faim. Okay, we have avoir chaud, to say to feel warm or to be warm. We have avoir soif, to be thirsty, avoir soif. We have avoir raison, to be right. We have avoir tort, to be wrong. Avoir froid, to be cold. Okay, note also that when you're saying your age, you also use the verb avoir. Okay, you are going to say something like I have this age. Okay, for example, let's say I'm 12 years old or I am 15 years old. In French, I'll say j'ai 15 ans. I have 15 years, something like I have 15 years. J'ai 15 ans. Tu as 20 ans, to say you have 20 years. Il a 80 ans. Okay, so things like that. I am so grateful that you're with me till the end of this lesson. I am longing for the next lesson. Thank you so much. And bye-bye. Au revoir. Merci beaucoup d'avoir été avec moi dans cette leçon. Merci et au revoir.